centerforest.com.
Okay, students, now we are into the next lecture of chemical kinetics. In the first lecture, we have studied about the introduction, and second lecture, we have studied about the order of reaction and molecularity. Now, we are going to study in this session, we are going to study about the differential and integrated rate law. What we are going to discuss? We are going to discuss differential and integrated rate law. These are the two things we are going to discuss. Okay, so out of this, more important is integrated rate law. More important is integrated rate law. Okay, integrated rate law is more important in comparison to differential rate law. So let us take from the first zero order reaction. What is the first one? Zero order reaction. Okay, one by one, if you study zero order reaction carefully, then first order will be easy and second order will be easy. Understood? So if you pay attention very carefully right from the beginning, it is going to give you result in the future session. Okay, I think all of you have subscribed and pressed bell icon so that you should get notification when I add one more lecture of this series, and many series are continuing. Okay, so depending on the time availability, I will be keep on uploading the videos. So to follow through them, you have to inform to your friends also, do the same. Okay, so first let us see about the zero order reaction. Zero order reaction means, suppose a reaction is there, A gives product. What is the reaction? A gives product. Okay, now in this one, rate of reaction, what we call it as rate of reaction. So A is a reactant, so minus dA. As I told you, for the reactant, what should be the one? Minus should be there. Product should be plus, reactant should be minus. Okay, so minus dA by dt, okay, is equal to, according to rate law, what is the formula? K into A to the power of 0. Why 0? Zero order reaction we are deriving. Understood? Now this is called as differential rate law. What it is called as? Differential form of rate law, because d by dx, d by dt is there. Because of this, this is called as a differential rate law. Now we are going to write the integrated rate law. For that, this differential equation is to be, what it is to be done? It is to be done with integration. Okay, then it will be converted to integrated rate law. So numericals, most of the questions will be integrated rate law only. And this chapter, like states of matter in 11th class, in this chapter, this is graph-based chapter. Okay, so more graphs you understand, more graphs you revise, then more easy this chapter is. Okay, now let us see the differential rate, integrated rate law. Minus dA by dt is equal to K into A to the power of 0. So for differentiation, B should be on the other side, either side. Okay, so what I will do? A to the power of 0, so it is equal to 1 already. Minus dA is equal to K into dt. What is this? K into dt. Okay, now integrating on both sides, as a short form, what I write? IOBS. What is IOBS? Integrating on both sides. Minus integration of dA is equal to K into integration of dt. Okay, so let us take, at the time t, the concentration. Concentration is, when time t is equal to 0, then concentration of A is equal to A0. Okay, when time is t is equal to t 5 minutes, like that, then A is equal to A. Okay, so this mainly you should remember this. A0 means initial concentration. Okay, integration of A, is equal to what? A is equal to K into T. But problem is that integration constant C will be there. What will be there? Integration constant C. Let us take this as equation 1. Okay. As of now, what we got, is it understood? Minus dA by dt is equal to K into A to the power of 0. Minus dA is equal to K into dt, integrating on both sides. So integration of dA is equal to K into integration of dt. So when t is equal to 0, A is equal to A0. That is initial concentration. At any given point of time, we will write as A. Okay. So for finding out the integration constant C, everywhere we are going to apply the same principle. So better to remember that. Okay. What is that principle? If t is equal to 0, then what I will write in place of A, I will write it as A0. Okay. So I am going to write it here. So in place of A, what I should write? A0 is equal to K into, in place of T, it will be 0 plus C. So that means C is equal to what simply? Minus A0. Okay. So equation 2. From this equation 2, I am going to substitute C value. I am going to substitute C value in this formula. Then what I will get? Minus A is equal to K into T minus A naught. What is this? K into T minus A naught. Is it looking nice? No, it should be rearranged. Okay. On rearranging, it will be getting into the beautiful form. Okay. So what is that beautiful form? A0, I will bring it here. A0 minus A divided by, suppose if you want K, then you keep the K that side and it will be like this. Okay. So this is the integrated rate law. Okay. So I am clearly writing it again. So finally, what we got is A0 minus A is equal to K into T. Okay. So normally what we take T, suppose if we want, T is equal to A0 by K minus A by K. Okay. So K is cross multiplied and separated. Is it understood? Now this is one form. Otherwise what you can write? T is equal to A0 minus A by K. Anything, whichever you feel comfortable, you should remember that. This is the, what it is called as integrated rate law. Integrated rate law of which order reaction? Zero order reaction. Okay. The same procedure you will follow everywhere. You will follow same procedure in first order also, in second order also, in nth order also, you will follow same procedure. Process is same, but answer will be different because of the difference in power. Okay. So is it understood? Will you remember? Now there is small additional topic to this. What is the topic? Half lifetime. Okay. So here only if you do it, it will be easy for you to understand. Okay. So note down this, take a note of it and try to remember it. If you are not able to remember, try to write it 2 to 3 times. Okay. Then coming to the half lifetime. Half lifetime. Okay. What is half lifetime? It is denoted by T half. Okay. It is time taken by, it is time taken by reactants to become half of its original or initial. Initial will be more appropriate term. Initial concentration. Initial concentration. Suppose if you take initially 100, time taken to become 50. If you take 20, time taken to become 10. If you take 10, time taken to become 5. Whatever the initially you take, that time taken by it to become half of the original quantity, initial concentration, that is called as a T half. That means when T will be T half, okay, then A leftover, what is A leftover? It will be half of the initial concentration. Okay, this condition you will remember, if whenever you put T is equal to T half, in that question what you will write in place of A, you will write as A0 by 2, the time taken by a reactant to become half of its initial concentration. Is it understood? This is about the half life time. Okay, now this condition we are going to substitute. These conditions we are going to substitute in which law? Integrated rate law. Then you will get formula for what? Very good. We will get formula for the half life time. Okay, so I think I told you to remember or not, A0 minus A divided by K is equal to T. This is the integrated rate law of the which zero order reaction. Now what is the condition I told? If T is equal to T half, then what you write? A is equal to A0 by 2. So are you ready to put it into this? So A0 I will not disturb, but in place of A, what I will write? A0 by 2 divided by K, and in place of T, what I will write? T1 by 2. Okay, so what it will become? A0 minus A by A0 by 2, it will be half. So A0 by 2K is equal to T half. Is it understood, students? So this is the formula for T half. Okay, so from this you should remember the two things. T half is directly proportional to a T half depends. First of all, T half depends on initial concentration. Okay, what it will depend? It will depend on initial concentration. Second thing you should remember is T half directly proportional to initial concentration. Okay, it not only depends, it also directly proportional. This is in numerator, this is in numerator. That means more initial concentration you take, more will be the time taken by it. Is it understood? So these are the differential rate law, integrated rate law, and half life time. All the three topics of zero order reaction is completed. Okay, any doubt about this? I will write a short note here. Okay, first, is it visible? Okay, first differential rate law, minus dA by dt is equal to K into A to the power of 0. This is the differential rate law. A0 minus A by 2 or by K is equal to T. This is integrated rate law. And T half is equal to A0 by 2K. Okay, so remember all these three formulas. Likewise, keep on accumulating. This we have studied for zero order reaction. Likewise, you will get for first order reaction, you will get for second order reaction. Other than this, I told you this chapter is very important for the graph point of view. Okay, so be ready for the graphs also. Okay, okay, now let us study some graph related to zero order reaction. Okay, so this I have changed the format required as per the graph. I have observed that on y-axis it is A, on x-axis it is T. Actually this is a formula, but to make it compatible to this equation, this A must be here, so cross multiplied and taken that side, this will become like this. Okay, now why I have done like this? Because y is equal to mx plus c, exactly fitting to this equation or not. So on y axis it is supposed to be A, and it is already there. On x axis it is supposed to be T, and it is T. That means this equation is suitable to that. Okay, now c, what is c here? A0. So concentration of A0 is here. Okay, C is equal to what? A0. Understood? Now slope C, negative slope or not, and it is equal to what? Minus K. So nowadays what they are giving, the slope they are giving, that means slope is equal to what? Rate constant. Slope is equal to what? Rate constant. Apart from the negative sign, the only value you should take for the slope. So negative sign only shows that it is decreasing. How much it is decreasing? Quantity will give you the slope K. Okay. First graph, I think, is it understood or not? Okay, very nice. Okay, coming to the second graph. Second graph, I am drawing between T half and A0. Okay, now you are the judge. You can identify. Once I taught you how to modify according to our situation, if this graph is told you, then you can identify slope and intercept also. In the previous graph, what is intercept? A0. Okay, now here, we are taking A0 on x-axis and T half on the y-axis. Taking x-axis what? T half, and on y-axis it is A0. Is it suitable? Very good, it is suitable. Y is equal to mx. So x-axis is A0, T half is y. Is it understood? So what is not there in this equation? Intercept is 0. Okay, so that means it will start from here. And slope is positive, okay? And what is slope? Slope is equal to 1 by 2k. So this is the graphical form of the zero order reaction. Is it understood? Two graphs we have studied in the zero order reaction, okay? Okay, here is the third and final graph of the zero order reaction, okay? Concentration and time. Concentration and time. If you draw the graph between concentration and time, okay, let it be concentration on y-axis, time on x-axis, okay. Zero concentration, zero time. Concentration increases, time for consumption is also increases. Simply, what is the dA by dt? Okay, dA by dt is equal to k. So dA is equal to k into dt. So more time, more concentration. Less time, less concentration. Okay. So these both are just y is equal to mx. Okay. And what it is equal to? Simply equal to k. Time and the y is equal to mx plus c. C is not there. That's why it is zero. Okay. All the three graphs, is it understood? Now the same thing we are going to apply for the first order reaction also. Okay, be ready. Okay, if you are perfect in zero order, then you will be perfect in zero first order also. First, what you should write? Very good. A gives product. Now we will speed up. Okay, and differential rate law. What we should write first? Differential rate law. Okay, what is that? Minus dA by dt is equal to k into a to the power of, that time it was 0 because zero order reaction, but now it will not be 0, it will be 1 because first order reaction. Okay, this is the differential rate law. Then to convert into integrated rate law, what we should do? Send the d that side and integrate on the both side. Okay, minus dA by A is equal to K into dt. Is it understood? Now what I told you, short form IOBS. What is IOBS? Integrating on both sides. Minus integration of dA by A. Okay. Integration of dA by A is equal to integration of k into dt. Okay, so I think you remember something about the integration of 1 upon x is equal to, integration of 1 upon x is equal to ln x. Like this, integration of 1 upon a dA. Okay, so it will be ln a. Ln a is equal to integration of dt will be t plus constant. Okay, so what we will take normally, equation 1, then what substitute we will substitute? Good. If P is equal to 0, then A will be equal to A0. So substituting here ln in place of A, what I will write? A0 K into in place of this, sorry, minus is there and plus C. Okay, so from this what I got is C is equal to minus ln A0. Now straight away I am going to put it here so that I am in hurry to get the answer. Okay, I wanted to get the answer. So minus ln A is equal to KT minus ln A0. Okay, is it looks nice? No. So what you will do, you will rearrange the terms. Okay, for that I will bring this side. So what it will become, KT is equal to ln A0 minus ln A. Okay, so but the problem is that ln A0 minus ln A minus ln B is equal to ln A by B or not. So K is equal to ln A0 by A. What is the formula? Ln A0 by A. Okay, so KT is equal to ln A0 by A. So I told you there is a separate video lecture for logarithm. Okay, how to find log without using, how to find log without using log table. This chapter requires that. Okay, so use that video so that it will be helpful to you. Now KT is equal to 2.303 log A0 by A. A0 by A. Okay, now suppose we want K is equal to 2.303 by T into log A0 by A. This is the integrated rate law form. What form? Integrated rate law form. Okay, so most important among the all integrated rate laws, zero order also not this much important. Second order is not much important, but first order is very, very important. Okay, now let us take A gives product. What is this? A gives product. Okay, so initial, what do you mean by initial? When T is equal to zero, this is zero and this will be zero. Okay, at T is equal to after some time T, then this will be A minus X and this will be X. Okay, so I substitute here, then I will get the actual formula. Okay, so 2.303 upon T log in place of A0, initial concentration is A and A is leftover concentration, A minus X. What is this? Is it understood? This formula also important, this formula is also important. Nowadays what they are doing that 20% consumed. That means here 100% was taken, out of 100% 20% consumed. This will be 80%. Okay, reduced by 20%, this will be 20%. This same thing I told you in the elevation in boil, sorry, relative lowering of vapor pressure also, the specialness of the reduced by and reduced to, there is a lot of difference or not. Okay, okay, so this is the two formulas. Will you able to remember these two formulas and how to use? There will be a question session in that, clearly I will explain. Okay, where examiner wanted to confuse you, but you will not confuse. Okay, so before the question session, I suggest you to go through the how to find out log without log table. There is a video how to find out log without log table. I think you will be able to see that. Okay, now coming to the this topic, the what you should do for half lifetime, for half lifetime. Okay, next topic is what? For half lifetime, what are the conditions you remembered? Okay, very nice. If T is equal to T half, then what we should do? A is equal to A0 by 2. Okay. Are you ready to substitute? Do you remember? Okay. So T is equal to 2.303 by K into log. It was A0 by A. Is it correct or not? Okay. So in this place, I am going to write T half is equal to 2.303 upon K. Log in place of A0 as it is, but in place of A, what I'm going to write? A0 by 2. Okay, so this 2 will be that side, and this will get cancelled. So 2.303 into log 2 by K. Log 2 is 0.3010. So then I will get 0.693. Okay, divided by K. Is it understood? This is the T half. Okay. So similarly, we have studied in the first zero order reaction. Okay. T half, first of all, that it depends on initial concentration. Here, independent on initial concentration. I will write it clearly. So T half up to here, is it understood now? So T half is equal to 0.693 upon K. Okay. First thing is T half independent of initial concentration. Okay. Sometimes they will give you hint for a reaction in which T half is independent of initial concentration. That means he is giving hint that use this formula or use as a first order reaction. Okay. Second thing, T half is inversely proportional to K. Inversely proportional to K. These are all small information are going to help you out solving large numericals. Okay. So next, what is the session we are going to do? Good. Graph. Okay. Are you ready for graph? Okay, graphical representation. Graphical representation of first order reaction. Okay, here the graphical representation. Rate of reaction and concentration. What is the formula? Rate of reaction R is equal to K into concentration of A. Both are Y is equal to MX. Okay. So then the graph must be like this. Like this or not? It is going to be R is equal to concentration. R is equal to K into A. Y is equal to MX. Now coming to the other form. This is very easy form. The main problem comes with the second form only. Okay. So in the second form, what I am taking on y axis, I am taking log A. What I am taking log A and x axis it is T. Okay. For that, what I will do is T is equal to 2.303 by K into log A minus, sorry, log A 0 minus log A. Okay. So T is equal to minus log 2.303 by K into log A. Okay. Plus 2.303 by K log A naught. Is it understood? So Y is equal to MX plus C. Y is equal to MX plus C. No, it should come this side. So what I should do? So this is the formula. T is equal to 2.303 by K. What is here? 2.303 by K log A0 by A. Okay. So KT by 2.303 is equal to log A0. cross multiplied this KT by 2.30. Log A0 minus A. I wanted that the straight line should be Y should be here and X should be here. For that, I am making all this arrangement. Okay. So this I am bringing this side and taking that side. Log A is equal to minus K into T 2.303 plus log A. So now it perfectly fits our equation. Y is equal to MX plus C. Okay. So what is Y here? Log A. And what is X here? This one. See, slope is negative and intercept is positive. Like this. Okay. What is this intercept? Log A0. And what is the slope? Slope is equal to minus K by 2.303. This is once a old question. Okay. So this again, there is a chance that repetition. Okay. Second graph. Is it understood? Suppose if the question is what will be the graph by taking log A0. A0 on x-axis, A0 by A as a total. Okay. So what is end time? T is equal to 2.303 by K into log A0 by A. It is very simplest form. Y is equal to this also it to be written like this. Log A0 by A is equal to K by 2.303 into T. Y is equal to mx. Okay, so y is log this one, x is t. Now c is not there, so it will pass through the origin. Okay, and what is the slope? Slope is equal to k by 2.303. Is it understood? This is the third graph. Now coming to which graph? Fourth graph, that is related to which? Very good, it is half lifetime. Best and easiest one, T half is equal to 0.693 by K. It is just like Y is equal to C. So T half here and initial concentration here. Okay. What is on x-axis? Y is equal to C. So this is one. Okay. And what is this intercept? 0.693 upon K, because it is independent, Y is equal to constant. Is it understood? So that is the derivation part. Today we have lot of derivations, lot of graphs. So better to draw it together and study peacefully. Okay. All the best. See you.